Welcome back. And so we come, as we inevitably must, to the end game. A pivotal game on which the fortunes of all three generations tonight could be won or lost. The task to be asked and the points to be anointed are, as I speak, travelling all the way from an Aztec temple deep in the Valley of Mexico in a special envelope sealed by the tongue of Hernan Cortes himself and which we hand-delivered to me personally after I say those all-important and by now slightly annoying words, may I have the special, secret, magical endgame envelope, por favor? Thank you. No tip today, I'm afraid. And for a total of 11 points, which means anybody can win, the question is, which generation is best at... making me breakfast. Wow! Wow. Yes. All right, now, for generations, the most important meal of the day has been breakfast, and the most important breakfasts are served to the most important people who eat them, and very often these people are so important that they get served their breakfast in bed. Right? So tonight, our teams must not only make a delicious meal for me, but serve it to me while I'm relaxing in this common or garden queen-size bed. All right, I have toast, tea... a choice of cereal and some orange juice would be nice. Oh. Whoever can serve me the most delicious breakfast in the least amount of time, but with the most amount of presentation skill, will walk away tonight with the 1957 Nobel Prize for Chemistry. You have 2 minutes starting from now. Some interesting facts about Breakfast in Bed. Although Breakfast in Bed was a hit for UB40 with Chrissy Hynde in 1988, it was written some 19 years earlier by American songwriters Donny Fritz and Eddie Hinton. Isn't that interesting? Did you know that continental breakfasts are available on every continent?
A lot easier.
Except Antarctica. Let's see how teams are going there. I can't really tell. I can't smell anything cooking, which does worry me slightly because I did ask for toast. And I did ask for tea.
Whoa. I'm going to make you wheat bix, even though you said cornflakes, because I feel like everyone's going to make you cornflakes.
That's nice. I like a bit of variety. Thank
a bit of variety,
Josh.
You know?
How'd you sleep, Sean? Did you sleep well?
I slept well, thank you, Charlie.
Do you have any dreams, Sean? If that's how much I like you, I'll sit through a boring anecdote about what you dreamt about last night.
Well, if you put it that way, it was very, very interesting. I was riding a bicycle with Enya. Well, anyway, Enya was on the back of the bicycle, and I was on the front of the bicycle. I was on the handlebars, so she was steering me. I was sitting in the basket, a bit like E.T. Anyway, we approached the edge of the cliff, Thelma and Louise style. I said to her, go for it. Anyway, we took off and we floated. We flew for about, I don't know, about 14 seconds and then plummeted to our grisly death at the bottom of the canyon.
This is fascinating, Sean. Fascinating.
Thank you.
And then what happened?
Well, then our spirits became one and we rose up to the great cloud god, Ugugu. Then I woke up and had to go to the toilet.
Sean, do we present this to you when we're ready?
Yes, of course, yes. Oh, we've got 5 more seconds, ladies and gentlemen.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, thank you. Oh, early, Amanda. Thank you very much. Well, what have we got there? That looks delicious.
We've pre-buttered
nice.
It for you.
Yes, you give me a lot of Vegemite, and I do like a lot of Vegemite. You give me
that's
jam.
That's what we heard. Oh,
marmalade, that's nice. Yes. Half an orange juice, but it is freshly squeezed.
Freshly squeezed, and thank you, green. Banana on the cornflakes.
Yes, oh, that's nice. Banana on the cornflakes, I like that. That's excellent. It's a B+, at the very least. May I see yours?
Vitamin yes. B.
Oh, hello, Sophie. Yeah.
Ours comes with... garnish. Now, here. See, I wouldn't possibly ever contemplate pouring your tea for you. I mean, that's just rude. What they did. You've got a pot of tea there.
A pot of tea. Well, thank you very much.
You can pour it out yourself.
I turn it around once. Yeah.
Sugar, butter.
And you've given me a choice of apple, banana, and mandarin.
Yes.
And flour, if I so choose.
And a choice of condiments.
And thank you. And I love fruit toast. Thank you. That's very nice. I'm actually. I'm actually slightly more impressed with this than I was with the baby boomers.
Really? Oh,
yes.
Thank you very much.
Not as impressed as I was with your wonderful story.
Thank you, Charlie. That's very nice. All right. Well, it's an A. It's an A. You have to beat an A.
Oh.
All right, Matt and Josh, what have you got for me here?
We've got some Weet-Bix for some banana. I know how much you like banana.
Yeah.
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 What?
You
eat them every show.
The other two have done that already.
Well, that's not my fault.
Well, we're surprised.
Just because they're last.
Well, come on.
Oh, gosh.
That's all right. What have you got on my toast there?
That's the fruits. I've got just two different jams on two different bits. I like your face.
No, I'm sorry. Please take it away. I don't want that. I don't want that. Well, all right, all right. I'll be fair. Audience, who do you think should win? Gen Y? Generation X? Or the baby boomers? I'm happy to play the popular game. I'm going to give it to Gen Y, as you wish, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations, Matt. The Nobel Prize for Chemistry. Well done, Josh.
Thanks, Sean.
Very well done. Oh. Very well done indeed.
Awesome.
Please thank our guests, Greedy Smith, Sophie Lee, and Matt Lee. And please also thank our team, Obersturmführers, Amanda, Charlie, and Josh. And how did you go at home tonight? If you lost, don't worry, winning isn't everything. If you won, well, winning is everything, and well done. Until next week and afterwards too, I trust, I'm Sean McAuliffe. Good night.
Oh, but a hell of a day.
Oh, Charlie, tell me about it.